What up? Welcome. Bienvenidos. ¿Dónde está mi burrito? Yo, what's up, everybody? Today is day 400. Holy crap. It's freaking day 400. Yeah. Wow. If only there are other four things today I could just notice, and then there'd be so much synchronicity and stuff. What's up, T? Yo! Did you have the window open? Yeah, what's up, Saladongs and Arcane? Day 400. Take out that spiritosis. I don't even know what that means. You had the window open, yes. Yay. Today I'm going to be doing the final puzzle for the Swordless 2 dungeon. And it is going to involve toggles. So there's going to be a toggle switch thing somewhere. So, like, you'll stand up, there'll be, like, two big switch things you on the ground, and you can, like, stand on one of them, and it toggles up a bunch of tiles, or right, down the other tiles. Kind of like Super Mario Brothers. Oh, alcohol. Spirits. No, I don't think I'm actually going to use switch statements, but you know what, hell, let's make sure that, yeah, why not, switch statements it is. You coded 2,500 lines of code in 10 hours? Whoa, what are you coding? That's a lot of coding to get done in that amount of time. You had a semester project due. Oh, it's a semester project, huh? Oh man, you've been burning the oil, burning the midnight oil. Yeah, you got it done, man. Is it done? So the first thing I'm doing here for the code is making it so puzzles don't ever get thrown at dead ends, because it's so stupid to get into a puzzle room and then, like this one right here, this is a total dead end right here, and it's just stupid because a lot of times puzzles are used to get out of a place, and the same thing for the Swordless Dungeon. It's just not as ideal of a place to put puzzles at the end, dead end. So I'm going to put them other than dead ends. You're burned out. It's not finished. But it's enough to get you through? All right. Well, when you get all done, get some good rest, man. What's up, Red Sands? Thank you. Happy 400. Day 400. It's a lot of days. A lot of development days. Yeah, I'm looking forward to day 420 as well. What's up, Zyger? Yo. Happy to have y'all here. Welcome, welcome. Hellos to everyone. Okay, so we'll add some weight or reduce weight if a dead end. What's happening? Bafu's, he was here yesterday after a while. Yeah, Bafu got here like later when Boogie arrived. Bafu was there. What's happening today? I'm making a switch. So I'm working on the puzzle. The last puzzle for this Swordless Dungeon is going to be a switch puzzle. Let me show you to what I mean here. Running. So somewhere in this swordless dungeon, there's already two puzzles that are kind of, you know, they're working, they're good, they're different than the other puzzles. But the last puzzle is going to be something where you have to toggle a switch. So imagine there's something, some kind of plate, like a pressure plate or something like that, on the ground right here. It's square-ish, and another one too, two pressure plates. And some pillars or whatever that are up, and some pillars that are down. And so when you step on one pressure plate, it causes the pillars on one side to go down and the other side to go back up. And that affects the whole dungeon. It's kind of like the switches in Super Mario World, you know, like where you would activate something and then those blocks would appear. Kind of like that, except that it's just toggling them up or down. So yeah, it's like basically a toggle switch. So that's what that's going to be. And then the last puzzle is basically you have to have that toggle switch in a certain state to be able to solve the last puzzle in this dungeon. So it's kind of a meta. It's kind of a meta puzzle in the sense that you have to go. It's just you have to go to a different area. You have to be in two different areas to solve a puzzle on one area, kind of, you know. And it has to be in a certain state to do that. And then also what that could do is, since it affects the whole dungeon, we could, as long as you, if you toggle them, so that you can solve the puzzle, then it's also going to close off the path to, like, the exit here, before the boss and everything, all that. So maybe there's some tiles here which are blocking your path, so you can't get past here unless you have the puzzle state or the switch state in a down or up or whatever. So yeah, just doing that today, and starting with going and making puzzles patterns so they're not ever in dead ends, because it's not as ideal to put them in a dead end. Alright, so if the doors type is not door secret open, and not secret closed, and not secret path, then the number of doors plus plus. So if we only have one door or less, well, it's impossible to have a door. No, it is possible to have doors. If the number of doors is less than or equal to one, then the weight just becomes like maybe an eighth of what it was. So that should basically not change the dungeons at all, really, except to favor puzzles not in dead ends. So let's see what that does. I'm going to compare this to the old one. Okay, so it moved the... That's puzzle B. It moved it to there. It moved the Verloc to here. It moved puzzle C to there. Puzzle A is now here. Okay, this really did shift everything around in this whole dungeon, but that's okay. That's good. That's what we expected anyways, right? This is now, the goal of that was to move this puzzle right here. Puzzle C was not a good fit because it was a dead end. So let's see what other dungeons this might have affected. Go back to dungeon one. So it. Dungeon one, unaffected. Very cool. I like seeing things that were not affected at all. That just means that, you know, it really didn't change much. And yeah, the less the world's changed, the better, because I don't really want to pull the rug out from anyone playing the game right now. But in the sense, but it, you know, still, like, eventually the rug will be, have to be pulled out, you know. Okay, this is kind of an example right here where this actually might have hurt this dungeon a bit. Maybe, or actually the weight needs to be. So basically right here, this was kind of a good fit for this to put a... to put this puzzle right here at this dead end, because the... it, instead, it put it right here next to the entrance, and really, there's no other place it could have put it. Except for here. Oh. Place a hidden item right there. This would have been a good place for a puzzle. Nice, Arcane. Thanks, man. Yeah, it's starting to get that way. There's still about three or four dungeons left to make look a little more unique and interesting and add new bosses and stuff. But yeah, it's getting there. The new fire dungeon's a lot better. The ice dungeon's really good. The now there's this new Swordless 2 dungeon that'll be come out this weekend. Yeah, and then there's also going to be an acid dungeon, a lightning dungeon, and a fear dungeon. So there's three more dungeons. And then there's also the tower. There's like one more kind of, but it's not really a dungeon. It's more of a either a boss run or just a boss fight. I'm not sure. So I could favor putting hidden items in dead ends. And that would help this out here. So I'm gonna go to dungeon.h. The dungeon door is valid, is type match. I'm gonna go. Oh, is type match. This function would work nicely. Switch door types. Lurkin in the Kirkin. Okay, doors secret. So I'm making a vector. It's all set up with door types that are secret. So I can easily check if a door is secret in one line. Well, in a shorter one line of code. Sounds easy. It is. I know I'm using this elsewhere, so I'm gonna fix that right now. So d dot is type match for k doors secret closed open path. That's shorter, very nice. Or door dot type is open, close, or secret path. So this is the same thing. If door dot is type match k doors secret. Oh, all right, man. See red sands. This one is if not d dot is type match secret. Doors type match. Okay, so that was just a brief little refactor there to get the basically to not duplicate some code. So now I need to test to make sure I didn't break the whole game there before I proceed. Okay, good. So dungeon two, same situation. Good. Okay. I should also briefly go to dungeon one, make sure I didn't mess all that up. Okay, good. We got a regular door here. Locked doors here. This should be a secret path. Good. This should be a bombable wall. Okay, good. Everything appears to be fine. Okay, so the next thing is to make it so when it places items, it's going to favor putting items in dead end rooms. All right, now if the number of doors is less than or equal to one, it's also gonna favor it. Okay, and now just make sure that it didn't break all the rooms already. Now we got dungeon one is the same. Okay, oh, it did move this to be a secret room, but didn't put a hidden item there. It moved the hidden item to there. Wait, this kind of broke something here. Not really broke it, but wait. Oh, I already had this in place. Or art of doors size equals one. Gotta be careful when making these proc gen changes to that basically affect the entire game. Okay, that didn't fix it. Maybe I broke it when I changed this art op flags. Or this. Could just be that. What? Okay, I gotta move this back to how it was. Gotta reestablish that because I don't want to break the dungeon. So if not equal to none, return negative one, and then after you check for secrets, if, oh, yeah, okay, that totally broke it. It was just that. I was checking the flags too soon. What's up, clock? Howdy, howdy. It's going good, man. Yeah, working on the last puzzle for the Swordless Dungeon. Right now I'm rearranging how puzzles are put in the world, so it favors putting puzzles not in dead ends. And then conversely, it favors putting hidden items, or actually all items, in dead ends. So if it finds a dead end, it's like, oh, I'll put an item there. If it finds, and then it just doesn't use puzzles. Okay, good, there, fix that corridor. Back to how it was. There's that hidden item. There's that hidden item. Okay, so now we should be able to prefer dead ends like that instead of like this. And this, I think, can just be 1.0 plus difficulty. All right. Now we have a reward item here instead of an item. That's because it, where did it move this other hidden item? There's one hidden item there. Wait, what? Where's the other hidden item for this dungeon now? Oh man, I'm confused. I don't know what happened. Maybe prefer dead ends should be at the end. I'm noticing how important this order is here in this function. This is freaking all important ordering. Okay, come on, no whammies, no whammies. Yay. We once again have a hidden item there, hidden item here. And that's great because this is a dead end. And this is a secret room. So these are totally preferable places to put items. And then this is also a great place to put a puzzle because it's far away from, or somewhat far away from the entrance, and it has plenty of doors around it. So if this were a puzzle related to, you know, it's not like you go into this room, you get trapped in it or whatever, and then you have to solve a puzzle, and all you do is get out of the room. That would be so stupid. That's the whole point of moving these puzzles away from the dead ends, is that, you know, you don't want to go to a puzzle room and have it be a dead end. When you solve it, you're like, what? I just solved that for nothing? Let's see what it did to dungeon two here. We got a hidden here, hidden item there. A and C are now here. B's here, hidden item there. Okay, here's something where it should increase that weight there. Yeah. Nice, right on. Yeah, they are. They're super handy. I think it might be the weight. It might have just the weight for the weight for a dead end should be higher than the weight for what do we have here? What is causing that room? It's not a secret room. Doesn't already have an item. Doesn't have any flags already. Oh. Oh, it's the difficulty. This needs to be like at least 1.25, I think. So that would, if it has number of doors is just one, this is a preferable place for a hidden room right there, or hidden item. And instead it was putting it there. So let's see if that works to move. We want this to be, wait. Oh, yeah, see, this has nothing to do with if it's near the entrance. Okay. It's still putting that right there. Well, let's turn on full on debugging. Oh, that's not gonna work. I'm really curious why. Why would we put a hidden item there? Is there. It's not the goal item, it's not the boss item, it's not a gate item. It's gotta be this. Okay, too much fucking around with it. Can't continue. Gotta move on. All right, that kind of improved this dungeon. Let's see what it how it affected dungeon three. Puzzle there. That works. It's got two doors. Puzzle here. That's a good place for a puzzle. What was it before? Okay, I just kind of adjusted things slightly in this dungeon. All right, it's all fine. Let's look at dungeon four. It moved the puzzle, a puzzle to there. It had a puzzle here in this corner, but now it doesn't. Put it here more in this central location. This is the big thing, though. It didn't put that puzzle at the end, that dead end anymore. Okay, I'm checking this in. Just make sure I didn't break anything with my check-in. This is checking if the door type is secret open or secret path or closed. Okay. Prefer puzzles to not be in dead ends. Next up, I'm gonna draw some stuff. Draw some stuff and stuff for the puzzle, the pillars that can go up and down. And And the pressure plates that you step on. So we're going to need a couple different tile types. And a custom function for each of those tiles. Yeah, it is. Yeah. It is summertime. There's lots of people traveling and stuff right now. So we're going to need a tile type for the pillar when it's like yeah, right. Yes. We'll call this K tile toggle pillar 0. And there's a K tile toggle pillar 1. So there's two different pillars. You know, 0 is the one that would be down by default, 1 is the one that would be up by default. And then we also need a switch tile. And those also, we need two tiles for both those as well. K tile toggle switch 0, toggle switch 1. And the area.h toggle pillar 0, toggle pillar 1, toggle switch 0, toggle switch 1. Boom, get all that compiling so I can start drawing things. I'm going to start with the inspiration of the button. Button upward and button downward. But just button downward, actually, is all we need. This is kind of what I got in mind for a button, for this toggle switch. But not quite as many runes, so different looking runes and stuff. Maybe they should be diamond shaped too. Call this one toggle pillar 0. One of them will have a certain color, the other one will have a different color. So this is toggle pillar 0. Yep. Okay. So now, since I want to decide whether it should be diagonally shaped or rectangularly shaped, I need to kind of put it in the game first. So I'm going to render out it as it is. Toggle pillar 0. So this should go in common. All right, now in area patterns, we need a place to put this. Let's make room. Let's make some room here. We'll go to world. I think a good thing to do here would be just make a. I kind of want this, the toggle to be centrally located. So an ideal place for this switch would either be here, the entrance, there. What's up, Woogie? How's it going, man? If I made it a puzzle, there's a chance that the puzzle would be really deep. Unless. Ooh, unless the puzzles were rearranged a bit. Because the current one, let's see, it put puzzle A is the farthest one away. Puzzle B is pretty close. Puzzle C is pretty close. Why did it put puzzle A the farthest away? This one it put puzzle C the farthest away, so it's not like seemingly not sequential. What is it doing with that? Oh, this adds some distance from the entrance. Oh, and it also adds weight based on the before boss pause, that's right. And then additional weight based on the nearest puzzle. Okay, so it's very complicated how it actually puts, how it weights where a certain puzzle should be. All right, I'm gonna stop analyzing this too much and just go and put another puzzle in here. And we'll put the toggle switches on that puzzle. So there's now four puzzles in the Psychedelic 2 dungeon. Let's see where it puts them. There's A, there's D, C. They put all these puzzles right next to each other. Really? And we already had weights based on the distance from the closest puzzle. That doesn't make any sense. It should put... Okay. It didn't put them there, or there, because they're really close to the entrance. And it didn't put it here. Because it's really close to the before boss room. But here and here could have been ideal places for puzzles as well. They both have plenty of doors. Okay, all right. I can always improve this later, like the placement of puzzles and everything. But for now, I'm just gonna make it. Just gonna make this functionality work. So right here, this puzzle pattern D is gonna be the toggle area where you go and you can toggle which pillars are up and which pillars are down. So go to foes. You need to set up this last puzzle. Swordless. Oh, we're gonna need a new pattern. Pattern puzzle toggle. All right, and then shield 4 is going to become puzzle toggle. No item. Okay. Now in area patterns, we can set up the puzzle. Okay, so we'll do like W2 minus 2, H2 minus 1 is tile toggle switch 0, toggle switch 1 is on the other side, and then we'll do some other tiles above it. Where we got the pillars, so we can have those. And then we also need to make sure the areas can create these tiles. So we got K tile, toggle, pillar 0. Now we just need to create them. Okay, next, I need an entity for the butt, like it's similar to buttons. Button downward, I guess. Call this toggle pillar 0. And I got Taco Bell 0, 0, 0. It's gonna be the idle frame. Zero pound is the release. No mask, can't be hurt by stuff. Oh wait, actually it should be hurt by stuff. No flags, it has to be activated by the switches. So there's nothing that activates it. Flags. Instant recharge, maybe. Finally, we can run it. See if we even have one of them already. This isn't the pattern. That's not it. Is that it? Which one was it? D is right there. To hook up the pattern. Area patterns. We need a pattern. Wait, didn't I do this? Yeah, pattern puzzle toggle. Okay, nothing ever called this, so That didn't work. Why didn't that work with this? The foes should have triggered this swordless puzzle for set pattern puzzle toggle. Maybe it didn't. Oh, I need more debugging info. World verbosity all the way at 5. Okay, it's not revealing. Did I spell it wrong? All right, we're setting the pattern for X1, Y3, Z5. Shield 3, shield 2, that's it? That is really weird. Maybe I should just throw all these tiles at the entrance so I can figure it out. Because this isn't. I don't know what's up with this right now. We're going to add foes. Yeah, I can't mess with this anymore. Let's put this at the entrance for now. I'm sleepy today. So sleepy. Didn't get good sleep last night. Makes the next day hard to code, always. Okay, I'm just gonna disable that for now. All right, yay, we have one. Okay, so I'll just put the switch pillar there for now, and the switch pillar here, and the switches here, and we'll toggle them, get them working and everything, and I can figure out how to place them in this dungeon better later. It doesn't really matter at this point where they're placed. Okay, so I don't want it to look like that. I want it to either look diagonal, definitely taller, definitely not the same runes as this other one. Two colors, maybe yellow, purple, or something. It would kind of be nice if they were red and blue, I guess, could work. Or like red and blue-ish. Okay, so the question is, should this thing be diagonal or should it be rectangular? Make sure I got this is toggle pillar zero, cool. The heck did I just do? Oh man, that confused me. Take, what's up? Okay, I'll change the hue here. Wait, I shouldn't be drawing this thing all perfect before I make it. Well, why not? Okay, so I'm thinking red and blue. Maybe bluish purple. This is already pretty bright, but maybe take down the saturation a little so it doesn't look. That's all right. Okay, so like that. Not bad. A little taller. Maybe not. Okay, let's see what it looks like diagonal style. How the hell did I mess that up? It's just not Let's see if this is even. It's 14 pixels wide. All right, it is even. Oh, that has a bottom that's like that. So this needs to be 5 pixels wide. No, 6 pixels wide. Oh, it's because this edge has that. All right. Oh, it's just double that layer of shadow. Whoops. Drawing the wrong layer again. Damn it. Okay, I did all that just to see if it would look right. Let's see if it does. What's up, Salad Dogs? Holy crap, what's happening? There's a military coup going on in Turkey right now? Oh my god. Does that have anything to do with yesterday? Military coup, huh? That's not the nice kind of coup. Are there nice kind of coups? I don't think so. Oh my god, yes, I like it. I like this one better than the other one. Okay, diagonal it is. Diagonal it is. Let's put a couple next to each other, actually. Toggle switch zero, toggle switch zero. Toggle switch 1, 1. Yeah. Right, oh, there you go, yeah. One side backs down. It's like a peaceful coup. Right, yeah. There can be peaceful coups. Thailand has coups a lot. Every few years. Turkey. I wonder what the situation is there. I went in there and just boy, I wonder two of these. This toggle, there's two toggle switch zeros. Why was there only one of them? Does not make any sense. Did you compile? No, you didn't compile? What? Messing with me. Xcode's messing with me today. Oh man, I'm gonna get to bed early tonight and just sleep good. That'd be good. Tomorrow I'll be fresher. What the fuck? Why didn't I just made sure there were two of these and there's only one. That's messing with my head. I do like seeing them diagonal. At least there's that. If you like seeing them capable, but I'll never be as cool as Jib. Oh, that's awesome, Boogie. Dude, I haven't noticed that before. Yeah, this is a good enough size. Any bigger, it would be kind of a little too big. This one's actually kind of big. Okay, getting rid of this old pillar and the old shadow and this weird other shadow and these things. You said that for a while now? Ah, I never noticed. That's a good one though, dude. Good one. It's strange that I'm slightly aroused by this. No, it's not. It's definitely not. I mean, this is definitely a phallic symbol right here. You know, it's a. Right? How else can I say that? How else can I say that? What? Yeah, dude, feel free to be aroused by that. Definitely not strange. If you're into that kind of thing. What's up, baby? Okay. One thing, the corner of it looks weird, and it needs a little more shadow. Good. Maybe 50% shadow. Drawn to Life? No, I have not played, but I just heard about it the other day. You love them? Nice. Okay, now it needs to be able to go down and up. And then we needed like a complementary one for the other type of pillar, the zero and the one. So the easiest way to do this is to make a. Holy crap. Select the fucking holy shit. Select. Oh, there. Yeah. Hey, jeez. Yes, I'm gonna do a layer mask based on the current data in it. So there. And then unlock those together so I can animate it. So we take this current frame as it is. Oh, also, this one needs the same kind of thing. Layer mask, reveal selection, layer mask. Wait. Reveal selection. Right, yeah, I heard about that. It sounds cool. You draw everything too, right? Needs like a cool click noise when it gets down. Oh, it's an old game? Oh, I didn't know it was an old game. Yeah, old games. I like old games too. I love my old games. Talk about zero render. Render it out. Kill everything else that's around it. Now we need toggle pillar one. And this one's just the same thing, but with a different hue for these Pokemon. Oh man, I saw the funniest Pokemon Go video yesterday. This girl complaining about how it took over her life. It was hilarious. And then I also, oh, I saw that there was a funny Pokemon video from PewDiePie. PewDiePie's got a great one where he dresses up in like camo gear. He pretends to be this dude that captures Pokemons and stuff. So let's make it red.113 it is. Place Pokemon Go on the phone where you travel to places. Yeah. It's a good one. This one I'm going to make a slightly different. This is and that's is, you know? A little slightly different design. You're trying to get the Squirtle? What's special about the Squirtle? Tell me about the Squirtle. I've never played Pokemon, any of the Pokemons, so I really don't get it. Like, tell me what's special about the Squirtle? Like, And I also wonder, are they all permanent? Like, if you find a certain character in Pokemon Go, isn't it yours? Like, no one else can ever get it? Or is that not true? Yeah, right. Yes, Azenris, thank you. It's a good point. Azenris, I saw your name on somebody else's. Yes, I did say I never played Pokemon, any of the Pokemons. I have never played Pokemon whatsoever. It says, oh man, I should be ashamed of myself, huh? Call myself a game developer. Are you even alive? Tell me, what's the appeal though? What's the appeal of Pokemon? I've never really gotten it, you know? Like, I've never been in much of a collector, I guess. It's a collecting game, right? That's all there is to it, right? Convince me otherwise, please, please. I'm trying to open my mind to this and like, should I install Pokemon Go? You're not allowed to see sunlight until you play. All right. Yes, hey there, see, somebody's on my side. Thanks, Zelda Dogs. You don't play Pokemon Go, but I played the handhelds. Oh yeah. So I guess I'll try out Pokemon Go. I shouldn't be like, you know, ignoring it too much. Whoa, that is weird, but I love it. I don't know why it looks so crazy, but it looks cool like that. I'm leaving it. That's awesome. I don't know how this one got so cool. Oh, because of this hue saturation layer. The way it is. Uh-huh. If you go out, find your own little Pokemon, and basically train it to fight and upgrade it with candy, you get badges for winning and being a good Pokemon trainer. Right? It's got RPG, puzzles, training, leveling, collecting. It's a lot of work walking around. Your Pokemon was your childhood? So, okay, tell me about, tell me this. Like, with Pokemon Go, if you capture a Pokemon, is it yours forever? Like, or I mean, like, can anyone else capture that Pokemon at that location? Okay, you could trade them, too. I'll be right back. Got a friend in town. Oh, you don't know about Go? Wait a minute, Azenris. You're saying Pokemon is your childhood, but you haven't played Pokemon Go? Why is that? Trade them, sell them, fight them, be a good owner, feed them, love them. Well, Tum T, you won 100 points. Congratulations. What are you going to do with your newfound wealth? Oh, you're not a mobile game fan. I hear ya. I hear you. Especially ones where they make you walk around everywhere. Come on. Okay, this one, I think we have succeeded in making this one look unique compared to the other one. So let's throw this in here too. It's Togepillar 1. Render. Mobile is my life, or more like a drug. You prefer feedback buttons over touchscreen. Me too. Yeah, I love buttons. I love buttons for sure. Goes a battery hog. You play this morning for 30 minutes and it drained your battery 37%? Dang. So I gotta try it. I gotta see what the hubbub is about, you know. Okay, so now we need to see this other tile. Create, toggle, pillar. Okay, so we got toggle pillar 1, toggle pillar 0. They're separate entities, so they can have separate graphics, separate sounds even. All right, see what it looks like. Oh, Azenris, I was going to say I saw your name on, for what's the game? What's that game called? He was just in the stream the other day. He was talking about his game. It's kind of like Minecraft in a way. It's a voxel game engine. Anyways, I saw a screenshot of the game, and there were a couple online multiplayers. And there was Henko, I was like, I know Henko. There's Azenris, I'm like, I know Azenris. Play Pokemon, you're good, 100%, play for 7 hours. Whoa, dang, you got a good battery. Next is Songbringer PDA app, take Jib with you, and every 1,000 steps earn something for the game. Rob the Swan, that's right. Rob the Swan's game. Yeah, totally. Yeah, that was crazy. I was like, I know who Azerus is. Kind of. Not familiar with Azerus' name. Alright, this is great. We got two of these. Oh, yeah. But the weird thing is, we don't have two, like, there's supposed to be two each. This is freaking me out. I don't know why there's only, but oh well. Let's put the pressure plates down now too. So since these things are diagonal, we might as well make the or diamond shape. We might as well make the pressure plates diagonally shaped too. All right. So we'll base it off of the same kind of thing. So they looked about similar. The switches looked similar to the pillars. Go to toggle pillar 0. We'll save as toggle switch 0. Toggle pillar 1. Save as. Wait. First, we'll draw the other one. Okay, so this is toggle switch. All right, time to draw a pressure plate thing. Okay, start with the switch part here. Okay, so merge this or permanently apply the later mask. How do I do that? All right, so it should be bigger for sure. Making it look good, making it look better. Oh yeah, oh, it's looking so much better already. Yes, more of this, more of these little dots. What are these called? Pixels? Pixels. I I like pixels. Give me some more. More dots. Okay, that's good enough for seeing if this is going to be looking right. Next up, we'll draw some of these glowy things. Perksers! See, I thought they were called pixels, but they're perksers. Thanks for correcting me. I need all the help I can get. Whoops. Keep on drawing things on the wrong layer. Can't animate things when it's on the wrong layer. Dadgubbit. Meh. See how this looks. Render this one frame, please. Thank you very much. Put this in the common folder. Right here, common. What's the other pixel? Pixers. Perksers? Perksers. And we'll create an entity toggle switch thing. Toggle switch 0 requires a valid pause. It's got a profile. Toggle switch 0 0. Toggle switch 0. No reflection. This thing's on the ground. Render Z order low. Always below stuff. Low plus something though. Low plus 5 at least. Sometimes flip category. Collision category. Mask none. 2 by, oh wait, this is like 3. Maybe 3. I don't know, we'll start with 2 by 2 by 0 and a half. 0 and a half? No HP. What in the world is this terrible looking language? What's up, John Gaines? English. It looks like C sharp if it lost all dignity. Do you want to have a flame war? Is this flame war? Is that the opening salvo? Also, howdy. What's up, howdy? Howdy do? How are you? What are you doing? What's your story? Oh my god, this is so weird. They put two of those down there. And it didn't put the switch. What the hell? This is so crazy. Pascal is best. Yay. I'm actually curious why you are referencing by string instead of variable. What do you mean? Referencing by string? What are you talking about? I'm not sure what you mean by referencing by string. So this is freaking curious as hell. Oh, did I forget to change the toggle to... Oh, you know what? It might have been this. No, I did this right. Pillar 0, pillar 1, switch 0, switch 1. A discrete string just sitting in code. Because I'm lazy. You mean this right here? I'm just using a string? Yeah, yeah. I'm just lazy. What if I change the name later? Yeah, okay. Okay, if you really want to go into this, if I really want to change this later, there's only two places I use this. There and in the data. So it's ridiculous for me to go and create a variable for this, a string variable for this, because I'm only using it once. And besides, the C compiler can put this as a string as well if I want to do that. So I believe you shouldn't try and optimize things until you need to, right? Or until you use things twice. So in this case, there's only two references to this, and one of them is in data that can't be changed by code. So there's really no point. I don't see any point to make this an actual string. So, oh, what the hell? This is weird. Toggle switch 0. I'm confused. Oh. I think I named the pillar wrong. Ow. I used the wrong profile over here. You can't go through the data and call it without worrying about string. Can't go through the data and call it without worrying about string. I don't know what you mean by that there. Sorry, man. what do we got? Animation toggle switch 00 has no frames. Why not? You didn't render. Toggle switch 00. Get status. It didn't even render it. What the hell? Oh, there it is. Toggle switch 0. Ah, I moved. Put it in the wrong place. You're familiar with Unity and C# method where you never could call the object since there's no way to. I don't know what that, I'm not sure how that applies to what I'm doing here. By string you call it. Yeah, strings are objects, if that's what you mean. Sorry, I'm not sure. Sorry, I think there's a few things lost in translation here because I'm not familiar with C#. I'm a little familiar with C#. I've used it a few times. I've made a few Unity projects, but like I prefer C++ myself. So all right. What kind of games do you make though, man? What kind of games are you making with Unity, John Gaines? Nah, man, don't worry. Don't worry. I'm here to hang out. Okay, hopefully that makes it so we have the switch on the ground this time. Yes, all right, we have the switch on the ground. But there's two of them. Nice, dude, you're making multiplayer games? Right on. That's cool. I'm glad you're making them for less than eight or less people, because, man, It's hard making multiplayer games. It's hard enough making it with eight players. My last game was real-time multiplayer, and it was hella hard. Dude, it took me a year and a half to write this game, and I'd say 9 months of it was just the multiplayer part. Syncing up data, getting people, one player, what if one player's data gets a little off, you know, getting the players back in sync. God damn, it was a bitch, to say the least. Toggle, switch. Oh, I'm no longer freaked out. I'm no longer freaked out at all. This is now makes sense. Those are the pillars. Do you have a game you're working on right now? Yay! Oh, finally, this looks like what I was intending. All right, so we've got a switch here on the ground. We've got, oh wait, can't walk around. Something's wrong with that. We don't want it to be a switch or category switch. We want it to be category, oh, maybe category none. No, John Gaines, I don't make maps in any programs. It's all procedurally generated with code. Okay, well, we need to, this can't be category switch. So we need to be able to walk on it. Now let's get the other switch. Cool, man. So, yeah, are you working on a certain game right now, or what? Like, something you want to share? Feel free to share links, man. Share links, share what you're working on. Toggle switch one. Okay, so this one's gonna have that crazy color hue, was I think 113. Oh, before I duplicate this, I need to do a little animation for the other one first. A short game about symbiotic relationship between bugs and plants. Cool. That's awesome. I like that concept. Okay, so we need a little animation for this. Starting with a layer mask. Using it to learn 3D modeling and animating? Cool. Nice, man. Okay, we got all these set up. So, frame number two. Go one pixel at a time here. There, now it looks like it's really sunken in the ground. Gotta make the sound effects. Thanks, man. Thanks for saying that. I hope it is. I hope it's a real I hope it's something that's really fun for people to play. Yeah, I know. I've heard of Zelda Randomizer. I've used it once. Wait, you're talking about Watch Zelda Randomizer? Is there a Twitch channel for Zelda Randomizer? I've used the actual program called Zelda Randomizer. Zero render. Okay, we should have the right frames. Yeah, switch 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Cool. And let's get that rendering. Oh, cool. It does races every week with the Zelda randomized? Yeah. All right, so once this is done, it's almost time to do the behavior. Gotta see how much time there's left in today's stream. If we can get this to toggle up and down. I'll stay on a little longer. I'm already at 2 hours, but I'll go at least like another 15 minutes. So we can get this toggling. I wanna see the one switches go up, the pillars go down, the others go up, and for it to all happen when you step on the switch thing and stuff like that. What's good? What's good is making this game is good. I love doing that. What about you, man? What's new with you? What's good? Still being professional, but novice-like. I've always liked your name, the professional novice. Okay, yeah, we can step on it now. Now let's make it so when you step on it, it'll toggle either these or those. Always. Yeah, you can buy it, but it's like the pre-order. So you can either pre-order the version. You can play the beta right now for $32, or you can pre-order the version that comes out later this year for $16. Life is good, right on. Life is good. Same here. Life is good. Right, so collision, we'll make it so it should be able to activate collision, actually. Mask friend. So friend can trigger it. Let's see if we can get this to trigger now. Would pull away my graphics tablet and focus on the code for a second. So an activate collision function. Toggle if. Yes, no, yeah, same graphics palette. It's still going. It's still alive. And it's still got the edge of it is still super glued. The super glue is hell, man. Super glue can solve your problems. You're struggling with Bluetooth programming? Oh, man. You'll get it soon. Girl, yes, she is. You can hear her probably. Yeah, my girl's got a loud laugh. You can hear her from miles away. She's got a girlfriend in town. They're just chatting it up right now, having glasses of wine. So, if the name of this entity, this is kind of a janky way to do it first, just checking the name, but like, this is quick and dirty just to get this kind of functioning right now. So, if it's the toggle. Switch 0. Yes, I had to super glue the tablet. Yeah, it was the USB port part, like didn't it would work if it was like angled just right, and then if it were normal, it would never work. So I had to like angle it just right and then super glue it in place, and it worked. Freaking worked. And then it stopped working again for a minute, and now it works again. Bluesy. Oh, Iron Chef's like just using Bluetooth is a pain. All right, so we'll look for all the other toggle switch zeros or whatever. Yeah, this is the toggle switch zero. And we're gonna look for all the entities with name component. Find all ids. Toggle switch, no, toggle pillar. Oh yeah. You get it though. You get it, man. Start with the simplest thing you can, you know? Like start with just getting one little tiny thing to work. And that's all you need, right? Once you have that tiny little thing working, it's like you'll get that feeling of success. You'll be like, "Yeah, I got that one little thing working." And then from there on, it'll snowball, and all of a sudden you'll have the understanding you need to program in Bluetooth and all that. Thanks, John, though. That's encouraging what you said. It's cool. Yeah, right? Yard by yard, it's hard. Right. Okay. So I want to animate the toggle pillar zero. I want to trigger its release animation. Or we can store HP. Well, maybe not, maybe not. Let's just trigger its release animation. You're about to delete a bunch of components. Oh, you're trying to get gravity and collisions to work? There you go. Yeah, get one little thing working at a time. Cool. Yeah. You've built in dislike for C++. You know what? You're not alone, John Gaines. There are a lot of people that have a dislike for C++. And I personally, the more I've used C++ for many of my programming years, but like the more I look at Jai, I can't wait for Jai to come out, Jonathan Blow's language, because it's just so much better than C++. No, so I can't wait for that. There's a lot of there's the problem with C++ is they tried to solve too many problems. That's really what caused it to be so bloated and like too much. It's just too much going on. You can solve things in too many ways, and so it creates, I don't know, it just creates it's a it's C++ is the language where they tried to be all and everything to everybody, you know? They have, yeah, it is, yes, it is significantly better than C++ 98. But yeah. It's like we need a language that's custom tailored for making video games, and I think Jai is gonna be tits. I can't wait for Jai. And thank you, Jonathan Blow, for freaking making that. Taking the initiative to make a better language. All right, I'll just get the render component. And you get render component. Render continue. Continue. C++ is your fave. That's right. Asmerus is a C++ god. He's amazing. What's up, Davis? Hope it doesn't blow. Boogie. Yeah. Render dot set animation release 0. Okay. Let's see if this works. So if this does work, I'll be able to step on this switch and it'll make the pillar look like it's going down. C sharp is a lot easier to learn. You like C better? Good for you. Yeah, C is a lot more simple and clean and everything. C is a beautiful little language. OOC is so much better. What's OOC? I've never heard of OOC. Oh, it didn't work. Damn you. Did not even hit this breakpoint. No. Wait a minute. Maybe I need to be collision category item. Yeah, I do my own pixel art. I do my own music too. OOC, I gotta check this out. Still no, oh man, still no switch. Ham into him and here. Small program language with a clear, concise syntax that compiles to C99. Nice. It reminds me of Ruby, kind of. But I never learned Ruby, so maybe I'm totally wrong. Hey, look, this has the same kind of syntax as Jai in ways. Thanks, Hellfire. So I'm almost done with my stream here, but I'm trying to get this one last thing to work where I can step on this switch and then activate these pillars to come down. But it's not doing anything yet. So we should have this did I put it on the wrong one? I put it on the wrong one! I could think this could be category none still. And we need these up here. And what else? That should be it. We just got category none, mask friend, activate collision. Thanks, Davis. John. right. Yeah, it worked. Oh, let's see that again without the whole trippy end going on. Okay, so today's mission is pretty much complete. So it's about dinner time for me. I'm gonna close down the stream here. As I'm just gonna show what this works. Look at this. We can step on this switch thing and those go down. Okay, so the concept is basically this switch here will make those go down and these go up or whatever. So it just toggles, right? And then there'll be another kind of switch thing. The red switch makes the opposite thing happen. So, there only needs to be one kind of switch that just toggles them up or down. So, that's the whole point. So, there'll be a meta puzzle. This dungeon is like, here's one of the puzzles in this dungeon. And then there's like, there's another puzzle or whatever. Where is it? I don't know. There's going to be three puzzles in this dungeon, and one of them is going to be related to these switches. So you kind of have to toggle the switches into a certain state, and then you can solve that puzzle. Yeah, Link to the Past style, right? Since you've been doing wrong data, it's supposed to... Yes, sir. Yep, I am getting tired. No, this is not manually done, man. This is a totally procedurally generated game. Here's what the world looks like. See, it generates all these things in memory. Every time it generates the entire world based on six letters. So you give it, like, the six-letter seed for this world is Xanadu. That translates into a number. That number generates the entire world. So if you use the same world seed, you get the same exact world. So you can share worlds with friends, play new worlds, play old worlds, whatever you want to do. There's no map editor. There's never any data saved to disk. So, thanks, Davis. Thanks, man. Cheers. All right, so yeah, that's it for today's stream. Thank you all for watching. This game's called Songbringer, if you didn't know. And it's coming out later this year. And I'm not sure if I'll be streaming tomorrow. I've been streaming every day this week, so I might take a little break. So I'm not sure when exactly I'll be back, but it will always be around this time. This is about when I stream. So cheers, guys. Have a good night, and thanks for watching again.